A program is simply a set of instructions for a computer to follow to make something happen. Really anything, and it's defined by you. You could be asking your computer to perform some simple math, or you could be asking your computer to make two enemies collide, one dies, and there's an explosion, and crazy things happen. Either way, the most important thing to understand is a computer is actually really, really stupid, which is actually a good thing. A computer will only perform exactly what you tell it to do, nothing else. And of course, what you tell it to do is called a program. Let me try to give you some examples of maybe some real-world versions of programs. Here's a short if statement. It says, if Jack is hungry, well, then eat food is true. Of course, that's what we do when we're hungry, we eat food. Here's a more complex example. If the current time is greater than or equal to work start time, and the current time is also less than work end time, well, then go to work. Else, party time! Modern programming languages kind of mimic what we already do in our daily lives anyway, so it's kind of easy to learn if you can find a way to associate it with the things you do in your real life, as I've just shown in the examples. Of course, this is a little abstract and even a little basic, and programs are actually a lot more complicated than this, but I hope you understand at least the basics of what a program is, a set of instructions your computer follows to perform some sort of action. The next thing I want to talk about are comments. You've actually already seen them in this script. To create a comment, you use double slash. This allows you to write whatever you want on that particular line. This is an example of a one-line comment. Comments are really, really great and powerful and important. If you're working in a large group, your comments can tell the other users or the other programmers what this specific chunk of code does. You can also leave other comments too, whatever you want. You can type out when the script was last edited. It doesn't really matter how you use comments, but it's important to understand that you have to use comments all the time, even if you're working alone, because chances are you don't just program in one day. You might program over months or even years, and if you open this script again, you might not know what you were talking about, and that's why you leave a comment. It's a very concise way to describe what's happening in your code. There are a few other examples for comments as well. Slash asterisk will open up a multi-line or paragraph code section. So here's an example of a multi-line comment. Slash asterisk will make anything you write after this, on this line or any other line, a comment colored green. The only way to close it is to type asterisk slash. This is really useful if you have to write a very large section of a comment. Sometimes you want to preface your scripts with a large description of what it does. So in that case, you can use the multi-line comment. Specifically in GameMaker, if you use three slashes on the first line of a script, two things could happen. If it's simply a code block used in an action section for an object, what you're doing is changing the name of that code block, seen here. This is a great way to tell anyone using your code, or just tell yourself, what's inside that code block. If you use the triple slash in a script, GameMaker will use something called IntelliSense, but we'll talk about that later when we actually talk about scripts. There's one last thing to know about comments, and it's probably the most important. When you're testing your game, and you're continually running it, and then going back and writing more code and running it, you may end up using a trial and error method, and you may find that some of your lines of code just aren't working. Now, of course, the instinct would be, oh, just delete it, but that's not good practice. It might be better to actually comment out your code. So if you have a line or a chunk of code that you don't want to use anymore because it doesn't seem to be working, just put slash slash or slash asterisk in front of it. Then, when GameMaker runs, it'll ignore that section and not execute that code, because GameMaker ignores comments. Why that's important is if you ever need to bring that code back, like if you were debugging that section of code and you just wanted to ignore something for a while, you could just delete the slashes and bring the code back in. It's much safer than deleting the code completely, because you might not remember what you wrote or even on what line you wrote it. I know this was just the basics and it's just to get you starting. But right now, I hope you understand what a program is, which is a set of instructions for your computer, and comments, which are a great way to keep notes in your code or even to edit your code for debugging purposes.